Hey guys, what's up? It's Finch here, and I'm going to be going over an OLT series just happening right now between Ox the Fox and Bea, two really promising up-and-coming players. For those of you who don't know, Ox the Fox used to play. He qualified for Smog Tour a couple years ago. He's just overall a really enthusiastic player. He qualified for the official ladder tournament. Same goes for Bea, and Bea's also been doing well in some other tournaments like Smog Tour and Smog at Statecraft as well, so I'm really excited to see both these guys play. I love highlighting when players that aren't like the most known get to play, because A, giving them that exposure is really cool, and B, it also just kind of shows you guys different styles, different ideas, and it really helps expand the metagame for everyone. It's kind of my favorite type of series, if you will. But yeah, it looks like Bea is using a bit more of a balanced team, and you know, Ox's team is categorically balanced as well. I think Ox is a bit more direct breaking power with things like Rhyperior, Dragapult, and Rotom Heat, all in conjunction with potential U-turn from Mandibuzz and Top Warp from Blissey. But at the same time, Bea has a nice win condition in Primarina. However, I don't think Primarina can be able to do much here with Blissey being used, especially if it's Moonblast or Psychic over Draining Kiss, so I'll have to wait and see. But anyway, we see some little item displacements from that Tangrowth being able to knock off the Mandibuzz and then Neopaddon in consecutive turns there. But Bea does have Rocks up, so that's good, as looks like Defog, Mandibuzz is going to be used from Ox. And speaking of some progress being made, we also see a Toxic on the Dragapult, but that Rotom Heat's very weakened now. And also, Tangrowth's going to come in, and that Dragapult's getting worn out between Toxic damage and now taking Rock Helmet as Tangrowth correctly comes in a U-turn. However, one thing I don't love about Ox's team is there's no Steel type. I feel as if it's probably a struggle to defeat. Actually, if it's Thunder, it's Thunder Wave Plus. Yeah, never mind. I was going to say beating something like, say, a Combine Blissey could be hard, but nah, so long as it's Thunder Wave Blissey, he could just Combine, you know, get that up and then teleport into the Rhyperior. And if it's Choice Band Rhyperior, he could just absolutely decimate it. And if it's not Choice Band, then okay, it might be a bit harder, but wait and see. I'm thinking the thing is that it can't be Stealth Rock and Thunder Wave and Teleport all on the Blissey. And if it's not Stealth Rock on the Blissey, then beating Combine Clef seems kind of hard. And this surely is Combine Clef, so I'm trying to figure out what it is. I mean, it already revealed Teleport, so it has to be Rocks. It's probably Rocks on Rhyperior. Yes, maybe it's like Rocks plus Heavy Slam. I'm not too sure. We'll have to wait and see. But yeah, should be interesting. I'm trying to think here. At this point in time, I'd say the play for Ox is just to go to Rotom Heat and try and get a Pain Split off. But he actually goes to it on a trick, which I guess isn't even the worst thing here, because he could still get that Pain Split off. And wasting the trick on that, it could have been a lot worse, is what I'm trying to say here. Yeah, it gets it up, and it's still going to be above Stealth Rock range, I believe. Yeah, so it could at least come in later, maybe. But yeah, we see Mandibuzz come in here on a U-turn. That's pretty cool. And now it's going to be able to probably get a Defog off, but it's got to be careful. Actually, the Clefable can't trick it. That's a cool part about it, because it's Heavy Duty Boots now. But he actually goes Blissey, knowing, okay, that's fine. He also can't trick me now, because he's Heavy Duty Boots. So yeah, it being tricked Heavy Duty Boots was really good for Ox. It's also going to be Combine plus Trick, which makes a ton of sense with Primarina support. So I imagine we're going to see a Thunder Wave here. No, it's just Teleport into Rhyperior, so maybe it's Thunder Wave list, and he's just banking on it not being a fast Combine Clefable, but a lot of Clefable have been creeping Rhyperior recently, and that's why you really want the Thunder Wave here. So, yeah, that's fast. It's going to... Oh, it lives just barely. I think that was sloppy by Bea. I think Bea should have found a way to chip that. That's really, really good for Ox, being able to survive that. If Bea found any way to chip that, then eventually in the long game, I'm fairly certain that Bea could have won, but it might have been hard, as all the Moonblasts initially were going to go into Blissey. The Teleport would have been following that. Maybe Mandibuzz or Hippowdon or Dragapult could have found a way to get some chip on it. But either way, Bea running fast Combine Clefable, which is a set that's very trendy right now due to the abundance of Rhyperior. And also, getting a trick off on something like an Iron Head Corviknight or outrunning opposing a Clefable can go such a long way. So I'd say it makes a ton of sense. But either way, Bea's now kind of without a win condition. We're going to see Jirachi now try and basically flinch down a Clefable. Yeah, and I think that this is kind of... I'm trying to figure out how Bea is planning to win this game. And, well, to put it bluntly, I don't really know how, because Primarina is walled by Blissey, especially if it's not Draining Kiss. And Dragapult is weakened and poisoned. Mandibuzz, obviously, in a win condition. Also, there's a Rotom Heat, Rhyperior, you know. I guess Mandibuzz is kind of hard to kill, but like you can't really, you know, beat it. And yeah, this is Scalding, so it doesn't look as if there's a chance he could break through. Wait. Unless there is? That Toxic Dodge was huge. Okay. I don't agree with it being Toxic Blissey on this team, to be honest. Thunder Wave into the Rhyperior seemed much better, but hey, to each their own. Is this a build without Stealth Rock then? It might be Stealth Rock in the fourth slot on Banded Rhyperior, but normally they drop Heavy Slam for that, but you really want Heavy Slam on this. I think this might be Rockless from Ox, it's fair. I've actually have a couple teams without Rocks nowadays. It's weird though, it's hard to say. And we're seeing subs, so Tusk keeps breaking it. So yeah, this looks really good for Ox, I'd say. But that Moonblast did a lot. Oh, but he calls it and he gets the Toxic off. Wow, what a great play. Saving some positioning there. But he's still going to end up losing a Pokemon or two to this. I imagine he just lets go of the Blissey here. And he tries to make use of whatever is left of the Rotom Heat, which is about 1%, to just dispose of this. Then we'll be in a 4-on-4 position. And from that 4-on-4 position, with the Jirachi and the Dragapult being so low and the Patron being asleep, it looks as if even something like the Tangrowth and the Dragapult should be able to do enough work. It is worth noting that the Rhyperior is weakened, so I don't think it's over necessarily. It's hard to say. Yeah, I'm gonna be honest. It's really maybe a bit more up in the air than I initially imagined, if only because looking at this Primarina, it's gonna be able to get a kill here for sure, and it only takes 12% poison. So therefore, you have to go to something like if Dragapult's able to kill this with Hex after, yeah, if Dragapult can kill with Hex after the poison, which I'm not sure. Okay, just let's go to Rhyperior. It's probably a good play. If it's sub Dragapult, that could be a trick too. Or you know what? Maybe he says fuck it, Rotom Heat, and he just Pain Splits here. Yeah, I think Pain Splits to play here. And if he Pain Splits here, then he's gonna be able to bring this down to enough range where it'll be in poison. Yeah, that'll do it. All right, and he goes to Powdown on what I'm assuming is the Pain Split, right? Yeah, and I don't know about that for Bea. I can't imagine the merits of preserving the Primarina. Maybe he was going for the choke and Volt Switch to get this killed, but either way, it looks like this Hippowdon is going to be basically useless now in the long haul, and the Primarina is also now very weakened and poisoned. Same with the Dragapult that's weakened and poisoned, and now the Dragapult's going to be taking poison damage on top of sand damage. I feel as if this was an ill-advised sequence there for Bea. It looks like he's just basically trying to preserve every single individual Pokemon, but not actually get much mileage out of them. And now you see he's got a 2% Jirachi, and a weakened 28% Primarina, and a 7% Sleeping Impoundon, and a 3% Burnt Poison Dragapult. And it's like everything is basically on its deathbed at this point. And I don't see a way out for Bea. It looks as if Bea is going to emerge victorious in this game. Ox to Fox is going to emerge victorious in this game as Bea is just drawing dead at this point. But yeah, no, that's good for Ox. Yeah. Anyway, Unfortunately, I don't see a way out. Yeah, I just don't. So it looks like we're going to be going to game two. This is a best of three for OLT playoffs. And for those who don't know, this is actually for the top 16 of the tournament. So both these players managed to win 3 out of 5, or just 3 out of 4, or 3 in a row, of the initial Switch qualifier. So 32 players qualified, but only 16 of them make it to like true playoffs. So there's a 5-round Switch tour, basically, to make it. So if you win your first 3 rounds, you're in automatically. If you go, let's say you go 2-2 in your first 4 rounds, then you play another person who's 2-2 for basically a chance to qualify, and that's pretty much what happens with some of these guys. So yeah, and it looks like actually this Mandibuzz might be able to survive the Primarina itself. So yeah, that's looking really good for Ox here. Yeah, and he's just going to let go of Rotom Heat, and that's going to be that. Sorry, it's just a little awkward endgame. I mean, there's not really much to say. He's going to go Blissey here. If it dies to a Dragon Darts or like a critical U-turn, then so be it. It's just not enough, I believe. As he might even go Mandibuzz, honestly. But actually, we see Tangrowth here. Yeah, that makes sense. Trying to punish the U-turn or live a Dragon Darts. And there's no way he's going for Hex into the Blissey, of course. And that's going to be that. Yeah, we see a Roost here, but again, it's futile. And it's going to be Infestation from Ox, which is really cool to see. Normally only see that with a pressure user, but yeah, it's still okay. Foul play there, Giga Drain. So yeah, it looks like Tangrowth's gonna heal up a little bit and Mandy Buzz is gonna start taking some damage, but honestly, it's just gonna be a long kind of stall sequence here. If the the Blissey can eventually come in and then get a roost off on a non-attacking move, as I believe it's in foul play to a kill range of 27, yeah. Then we'll probably be seeing, you know, I think you go Blissey here. Oh, okay, I guess not. But if you went Blissey there, it would have kind of clinched either healing or getting the drag bolt in when it was in range. So that was kind of my logic there. But either way, it's not really a winning battle here for the Mandibuzzes. You see Infestation plus Rocky Helmet is doing quite a bit. Blissey, okay, no, I just guessed that Ox is just fine playing it straightforward, but yeah. But yeah, no, it looks as if, yeah, finally he goes Blissey. I feel as if he should have done it when it was lower because there's a lesser chance of, well, okay, there you go. It would have been fine either way. So yeah, now Blissey's in and it looks as if it's pretty much over. I don't even know if a crit foul play would kill it, honestly. But yeah, that about does it. Also, let's say, hypothetically speaking, that the foul play came and crit here or something like that. As long as Ox is, Thunder Wave on the Dragapult or Will-O-Wisp on the Dragapult and hits, it's like it's over regardless. And yeah, you see U-turn there. Now we just see, I assume it's just gonna heal up. Yeah, and that the game is very much over. Alright. So yeah, that about does it. I don't even think a crit foul play killed, honestly, but yeah, no, there's no way out here for Bay at this point. And yeah, that about does it for game one. Alright, so now we're gonna be waiting for game two. Hopefully it'll start promptly. I'll keep you guys on. So, just a little bit of channel update. I'm going to try and upload this either on Saturday or Sunday. As I'm recording this, it's early Saturday morning. Well, not early Saturday. It's like late Saturday morning, I guess you could say. And, What else am I trying to say here? I'm going to be uploading some, you know, DLC 2 stuff, of course. It's kind of more the focus of the channel. I feel like I've kind of geared myself towards bringing these Pokemon, like, updates, if you will, for DLC 2. But I figured I'd record an OLT series just because you guys have been wanting some tournament coverage as well. And I'm not really as enthusiastic about the DLC 1 metagame right now. It's complicated because I really enjoy playing it. But the analysis, like, sharing for you guys, I feel like it's almost a bit of a waste, if only because the meta is changing so soon and you guys kind of want to learn the new meta. But at the same time, I know some of you guys are still into it, some of you guys want to see the tournament coverage, and most tournaments are still going to be in DLC 1 until, you know, those respective tournaments end, because changing format in the middle, unless you're Smogon Torx, apparently that's an outlier, which I don't agree with, but that's a controversial topic, not for here nor there, are going to be sticking DLC 1 format, so I'm going to be mostly bringing you guys, like, you know, laddered content, and maybe the DLC 1 release tournament, Tundra Cup, which actually is being hosted in the OU sub-forum, so if you guys want to get interested in that, check that out. I'll probably actually make a video on how to join that and how to access Smogon forums in general a bit more, because there are going to be a ton of resources. And by the way, I have to eat my words here, because Foul Play actually only did 2.5 to 3% to Blissey. So, it seems as if it was not in range of a crit anything. And, so that was a good play there by Ox. He didn't really have to time it in any particular way. He could just fish for as long as he wanted with Tangrowth, and then eventually been on his merry way. So, yeah. Anyway, we're waiting for game two here, I believe. I think it's game two. Set the chat game two right now for the fans. Anyway, what's up, guys? Love to hear how you guys are doing in the comments below. You know, what's been the highlight of your week? You guys excited for DLC 2? You guys prefer DLC 1? Any old gens you guys been playing lately? I know BKC's been putting up a ton of old gen content on his channel. It's been really cool. Yeah, and thankfully my OBS has not been fucking around today. I've been having a lot of OBS issues, but I think I've kind of gotten them fixed. Sometimes I just have to restart it when I'm between recordings. Sometimes I record like 2 or 3 in a row, just, you know, to get content up for the channel. And sometimes between them, like, it overloads, if that makes sense. And so I've been working on fixing that. I've just been, you know, restarting, and it's been more than okay. But anyway, we're kind of just waiting here for game 2 to start. Hopefully game 2 is not going to be some, like, medieval, like, stall-on-stall war. I'm really not trying to record that. In fact, if the game looks like it's going much over 100 turns, I might quite literally say, okay, this is what I think is going to happen, and just stop the damn recording, because I don't have the patience for that, and I have some other videos to record. So, yeah, no. Anyway, still waiting here. I'm trying not to pause, because last time I paused, my OBS also went, like, kaboom. And I'm still in the middle of fixing that. Thankfully, we're going to see game 2 here. Yeah, okay, we're good. So, it looks like another Primarina, but this time around, it's going to be on the Ox to Fox side. And as for Bea, Bea is running a cool Pokemon as well in Mew. So, looking at the teams, Ox is running. It kind of looks like the Como Wall Mantine, Clefable Zero, or Curum plus Age Slash team that we saw ever so often on the OLT ladder and other times, but unfortunately, it looks as if we're going to be seeing, we're going to be seeing, I guess, Primarina plus Jirachi. Primarina normally, I guess, is going to be the Curum. And Jirachi is normally going to be the Aegislash, but I don't think Curum really provides a ton defensively, so if you want to go Primarina as your win condition, that's fine. But he's facing a Ferrothorn here, so I don't know how much that'll be able to do. If it somehow gets a burn on the Ferrothorn and or it's not Power Whip slash Iron Head slash Bullet Seed Ferrothorn, then I suppose he's in business, but we're going to have to wait and see what the Ferro is. Most have been running Power Whip recently, so yeah, I think that being kind of ready for Primarina is of the utmost importance right now. And also, Jirachi versus Aegislash, definitely, prefer being age slash here, especially if it's a toxic variant hit mana buzz, but Jirachi should be fine. If it has a fire move, it actually might put in a ton of work. Either way, we're seeing Thunder Wave here from Clefable on turn one, as Beta's Clefable goes for Stealth Rock, so it looks like a fallen utility left for Ox to Fox, which makes some sense here. It's gonna hopefully set up for Primarina, but I don't know if he'll be able to do that much for Trick with Ferrothorn being there, especially when he's facing a Heal Bell. Heal Bell there from Bea, that's going to kind of negate the Thunder Wave-ness, the Thunder Wave stuff, so that's good. Rip here is going to come in here, hopefully on a knock. Softball, I think that knock was better there, but well, I digress. Either way, it's probably going to be a choice pin Rip here, so you're going to want to get out of the way here. Como Wall could be coming in pretty safely. Mantine, if you predict Earthquake, I suppose. I think Earthquake is absolutely the play from Bea here, so yeah. If it's a fast, it goes Como here on the Earthquake, and that is in fact Choice Band. It does a nice 55, and it's not leftovers in the Como, surprisingly, as we see. The Mantine double in here is probably a Rocky Helmet variant of Como. I don't like that at all without Witchclef, and I feel as if Bea is already in the driver's seat here. Ox is able to win game one, but I think that Bea might have an early lead in game two. We're going to see sub Dragon Ball, and yeah, that's adding insult to injury here, as it's going to be able to do a lot of work here, especially with leftovers. Yeah, but so it's going to live forever, basically. That Hex is going to be doing 40, which is more than enough, especially if it's Dragon Darts last. It's doing a lot of damage here, guys. But anyway, we just see a Wisp here. I guess trying to stall the Roost, and that's a really smart play. Yeah, and basically we're just seeing Roost being stalled. Hex are kind of going for it. And he goes Primarina here trying to catch out. Okay, catch a Wisp. Well, that's good for Bea, actually, because now Hex is going to do a lot. Hex might even 2 a kill here. Hex is going to do 48. That's way too much for comfort. I think if you're Bea, you switch out here conservatively anyway, because you basically thwarted the Primarina's attempt. But no, he goes for a sub-predicting. You switch, he catches the Zero Aura, and now he's going to be able to get a Will-O-Wisp off on that, presumably, and even if he just switches out here and not want to take the knockoff, it's like it's already basically taken out half of Ox's. I can't see this game going in Ox's favor at this point. It looks like Bea is just all over it. Let's the Pharaoh take the knock, which is totally fine. I assume it's just going to lay up some hazards here. Yeah, spikes, and spikes also look pretty good here. Now, Dragapult comes in here, now Nakomo. That was a little risky because it goes for Toxic, but it worked out, and now Clef's going to come in, and Clef's going to come in on a substitute. It's going to eat the Will-O-Wisp, presumably, to get status. And yeah, oh, and it misses. Okay, so that's something for Ox there. I suppose there's a chance. It looks like Bea seems really, really weak to a Calm Mind variant of Clefable. I wonder if the Mew is going to be like one of those like imprisoned sets. That could be interesting there. Anyway, I'm just going to PM here. Ox, Clef, item, Rocky Helmet, right? Yeah, it's Helmet. Yeah, well, there you go. Helmet's something that I actually popularized. I used it in Snake Draft against X-Ray, and it's pretty solid. So, yeah. I really like it on teams like this as well, because you punish your Shifu really nicely between Mantine and Como Wall already. You can kind of switch into both of them in like specific scenarios, so you don't need the leftovers, but also you're baiting U-turns because your Shifu's not making as much progress, so you're chipping it down really low, putting it in things like Zero Aura and Jirachi range, which is cool. Knock off there, okay, so that was a bit of a progress there for Ox, but then you notice that with Como Wall weakened and Primarina weakened and whatnot, nothing actually switches into non-choice Drip here either, and now it's less prediction reliant, as it should be quicker than the Clefable. And he goes for Edge into Mantine. It's obviously going to absolutely demolish it. So this looks like it's going to be a 1-1 series going into Game 3. Absolutely phenomenally played Game 2 by Bea here. Really picking up in the right scenario. So yeah, good stuff there. We're going to be waiting for Game 3 in a moment. We'll have to wait and see what happens. But yeah. Alrighty then. I imagine Ox is trying to, you know, find a way to come back, but I don't think he's going to find one, unfortunately. All right, well, we're going to see a Witch there and an Earthquake. That's going to try and heal up the Primarina, which is all fine and well. I just got to unclick this PM real quick. Yeah, sorry about that. And it's a quicker Rhyperior. Oh my god, it just takes it out. And this Rhyperior is just going to win the game in the spot. And that's going to be a 6-0 there. Alrighty, so we see a win there for Bea. It's going to even it out. That's funny how slow that Primarina was. I quite like faster Primarina in this current metagame state, honestly. But yeah, this Rhyperior gave no fucks whatsoever. I wasn't really too fond of Ox's team there. I feel as if the Kyurem plus Aegis Slash variant with that initial core, or even a different approach, but not Primarina. I think Primarina kind of makes it a little cheesy, but yeah, no, not huge on that alteration, but hey, to each their own. As for Bea's team, I'm kind of curious to see what the Muset was, but I guess we'll never know. Either way, though, sub Dragapult is just doing sub Dragapult things. It's a really good set. You know, some people have been talking to me, they think that Dragapult is kind of broken. I'm not there. I don't think it is, but I think that is a really good set. Sub Dragapult, and same with the utility Dragapult. I feel as if they offer a lot of merits to teams, both offensively and in terms of utility revenge killing. So that's pretty cool, I'd say. Anyway, next up, we're waiting for the following game here. I'm waiting to see what Ox the Fox has in store here. He always picks some pretty intriguing teams, so it's gonna be interesting to see what he comes up with. His last team wasn't really much of a hit, but I'm sure he has something fine planned up. And as for Bea, Bea is also a pretty dynamic player and builder as well, so that should be pretty cool. That should be pretty cool for sure. I love this background music, guys. It's called Secret Crates by Springtime Stroll, or maybe it's called Springtime Stroll by Secret Crates, but either way, it's pretty solid. I was just like, I vibe to this. Like, some people, when I was talking to them in call, it was funny that I was in call, and they're like, oh my god, I love hearing you with this background music. So I gotta, they put the background music on in the background of the freaking, it was the funniest thing ever. It was Swadaluan, actually. It was like a couple weeks back, you know, but it was funny. And speaking of joining calls and like interacting with me and whatnot, if you guys have any interest, I just made a Twitter account for my YouTube channel. It's pretty popping, it's pretty active, so it's pretty cool. Definitely hit me up with a follow. I'll be sure to interact. If you guys have any questions, it's great. I'll be sharing stuff in my videos and, you know, just Pokemon stuff in general. There's a ton of cool stuff going on that Twitter. So yeah, definitely check that out. And on top of that, if you guys want to get close with me in the channel, I got a Discord server completely free to join. I got like over 800 people in there. It's just a really nice popping atmosphere. I love talking with y'all. It's great. So yeah, I'm just trying to help you guys get better at the game and, you know, have, you know, some people with similar interests to discuss stuff with. But yeah, I feel, why not? If you want to join, great. If not, that's fine too. I'll be sure to leave that information in the description below. And yeah, no, we're just waiting for game 3 now. Figured to give myself a nice mandatory plug. I guess while you're, you know, out of checking out my stuff, you might as well subscribe to the channel. I mean, look, I look at these old demographic reports that YouTube gives me, and I see only like 63% of you guys have subscribed to the channel, but so many of you guys watch these videos regularly. And like, I'm like, okay, it's cool, you know. No big deal. You don't have to subscribe. You know, if you watch the videos regularly, I'm thinking it doesn't hurt you to click that button. It just doesn't. So you might want to just scroll down a little bit, just a little bit, and then click that nice red subscribe button. It just might be a good idea. Might just be a good idea. It might help. But you know what else would help with game 3? So we're in it, and that Bea brought the same team as game 1. Presumably, that looks the same to me anyway. Yeah, no, that's the same team as game 1. All right, so based off that, we know it's Subcommand Primarina. It's just standard Mandibuzz. It's Thunder Wave, Iron Head, Jirachi, Darts, Turn, Drag Pulse, yeah, standard Rocks, Clef, and Combine Trick, Clef. I guess Combine Trick, Clef does pretty damn well here. So another team by Ox is kind of reliant on Rhyperior for Clef. I don't think that's the best look right now. I don't love Ox's matchup. For, maybe it's Combine, like Psyshock or Steward Power, Clef by Ox to Fox, in which case, okay, fair. Wow, also, look how weak. Ox's team is the most Kyurem weak team of all time. Like, Freeze Dry just pick 6. Oh my goodness. Anyway, Rhyperior can do pretty well, as it can in quite literally any game ever. However, I feel as if here, I feel as if here, you'd really prefer seeing, an actually durable Clef check. And Combine Clef is pretty hard to keep in check, honestly, right now. That's like one of the main like issues in the metagame, I feel. So it's kind of worth noting. But trying to see what's going to be the play here. It's going to be a Jirachi lead. Jirachi and Clips. It's really good for Bay. I'm probably just going to see a Thunder Wave or an Iron Head thrown out here, I have to imagine. Alright, we see Iron Head on Zeraora. That baits an Impoundon, probably on a knockoff. Yes, it's pretty standard turns there. It's Leftovers Impoundon, but Leftovers no more. That's going to probably invite in the Clefable, Ferrothorn, or Slowbro in retaliation. Slowbro does watch out for Toxic. The other two are just completely safe, but they do take some damage from Earthquake that they have to recover off. So, yeah. We see Rocks set up for the Impoundon, followed by Rocks by the Clefable, which invites in the Jirachi, which makes a lot of sense. I'd imagine it might be a Fire Punch Jirachi, so we might have to be careful around it. But he just goes Slowbro, which is pretty safe, as it's likely not going to be Thunder Wave plus Toxic. Although that would be pretty cool, I got to admit. But it seems as if Dragapult comes in here now predicting the Slowbro, and that's something that you could definitely capitalize on if you're Bea. However, if you're Ox, I honestly just think you teleport here. I don't think you even let the Clefable get status quite yet. And you don't mind letting this eat a burn, as it doesn't really matter. Hex is super threatening anyway. It just doesn't matter if it's 2 or 1 Jack. You're not going to be staying in Dragapult in the long haul. So yeah, I think you just teleport here. If he goes for X, worst case scenario, you take, you know, 60%, 55-60%. If he goes for U-turn, then you get momentum. If he goes for Wisp, then yeah, you eat the Wisp, but it's better than Clef eating the Wisp right now, I feel. So yeah, I think that you gotta kind of make him work for that, take some chip for that, you know. But we're gonna wait and see what happens. Well, we see Mandibuzz come in here. I don't quite agree with that, honestly. I think that was a bad idea. Letting us take the Wisp this early. That makes something like, say... Actually, no, I actually disagree. Wait. So if it's Toxic Impoundon, then it can't get Toxic. Now, that's actually a really smart play. Okay. Yeah, I think Octoxy made the right play there. I made the lazy play. So good for Ox. I mean, he's probably going to go for a U-turn here, predicting the U-turn, and he does just that. That's going to allow him to get momentum, which brings in the Slowbro. I think that Ferrothorn with better spikes would have been really nice to set up here, as now he lets the Slowbro use the Toxic, which defeats the whole purpose of what he just said. Yeah, no, that's... Never mind. I really think he should have won Ferrothorn, but... Well, okay. On the bright side, he does now have a Future Sight stock, so that's going to bait in the Jirachi here, presumably. So, I don't know why he went Clef, but maybe he's got Knock? Thunder Wave. Okay, so he forced a Thunder Wave onto the Jirachi. I guess that's something there. Now, presumably, this is Thunder Wave, Iron Head, Jirachi still. It could be, like, Wish Last. It could be, you know, Fire Punch. I think Fire Punch is likely. Could be Wish Tech, though, I guess. I don't love Mono Iron Head, though. Probably just going to see the Slowbro come in here. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I think Slowbro's going to come in here now. It's actually Zeraora. I don't love that because you're taking chip. It's now barely above half health. It's really not the most durable Pokemon in general. So, yeah. I'd imagine that it's kind of walled by a Impoundon too, so I guess he doesn't need it, but it's always nice to have something to revenge kill Dragapult, and now it's not even able to switch into like a weakened Hex or whatever it might be, so gotta be really careful. God, I'm kind of tired. I should have taken like gotten some coffee this morning, honestly, but anyway, I mean, the play here is Impoundon, so are we gonna see Pharaoh or Slow? Slowbro, I'd have to imagine it's the play from Ox. I feel as if he's kind of lagging a little bit behind here. But we see a Impoundon here, but it doesn't look like Zeraora switched. Is it Grass Knot? It's just knockoff. Well, I don't think that's going to do much for him. I feel as if that was a really obvious follow-up. Yeah, I can't say I support I feel like Ox could have gotten a turn ahead of that, and he could have recovered on, say, a Spike. And I think those little turns, they definitely matter, because now he's got Clefable in, and it's like, okay. Clefable can fuck around with me. I don't even have a real, like, Carmine Flamethrower check. Yeah, and he knows it's Carmine Trick, at least, so. So it's Thunder Wave there. That's good. Thunder Wave off there. I imagine he can go for a knockoff there to get the leftovers up, but he doesn't, like, beat this Clef 1v1. Yeah, okay, so it's going to be seeing 18 versus 45. That's the move last time. I mean, yeah, you just combined up here if you're bad, honestly. Well, we see a Flood Power there, so I guess that's good for Ox. Wasted a couple turns, but he's going to find a way to get that Rhyperion safely and force a recover. And the thing is, this happens every time Clef gets in now, and that's why I don't love Ox's team. Like, it doesn't really have a check to Combine Clef. And letting the Relic to Poison means it's also not going to be able to, like, switch in and live a plus, like, one or plus two Moonblasts comfortably and teleport out, which is mainly how teams like this could function around it, potentially. So, yeah, it feels as if Ox is definitely going to struggle with this Clefable. And I think that's kind of due to uneven team building strategy, if you will. He definitely won game one off of having a Rhyperior to live the Clefable too. I think that Ox in general just hasn't respected Combined Clef enough in his building. Well, we see the Slowbro come in here now, but yeah, that's not going to really be able to do much. Alright, so yeah, he just left to go to Slowbro. He tried to teleport on a Thunder Wave, but he didn't get that quite luck. I think he should have fished with a Slack Off or two to try and get the full power, but I digress. Heavy Slam there, and a Powdown, obviously not going to do much. And I feel as if Bea has a pretty sizable advantage at this point. Like, every time Clef comes in, it's kind of, like, rough, I'd say. Anyway, we see Mandibuzz come in here now, probably on a knockoff from Pharos. That's cool. It might be able to get the Defog off here from Bea, but not going to really be able to beat the Pharos much. You can only get a knockoff there. So he actually did change sets. He made a knockoff over foul play, or maybe he's knockoff plus foul play. I feel like you need foul play in this, because especially defensive and Powdown is not a great long-term check to drill. So having a secondary check to drill, yeah, and he is still foul play. So he just dropped U-turn for knockoff. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. Zeraora comes in here on a Defog. That's cool, I guess, but just going to bait in the Apoudon, and again, we don't see the Zeraora switching. It is Grass Out. Wait, why didn't he go for it before then? What? He had a perfectly fine opportunity to go for it before, and he just didn't. Okay, I guess that's fine. Now it's going to threaten a Clefable. If he gets a full power here, that's huge. He gets a full power on the Rhyperior. He probably went for Trick there. I bet he went for Trick. No, actually, no, he definitely didn't go for Trick. He went for Moonblast there or Soft Belt there. Well, that makes his Zeraora a huge threat. Just trying to think here. So, Zeraora 2 kills this. It definitely kills the Apoudon with Grass Dot. Kills Primarina, kills Mandibuzz, kills Jirachi in 2. Dragapult. Yeah, so I think Zeraora is actually a really nice position now. Rhyperior goes for Stunners there. And Bea calls that, going to the Jirachi, good play there, but still taking 38%, which is a ton of damage. And all of a sudden, Ox is an I don't love that play. Oh, he gets the para. Okay, so he didn't risk like any nonsense there, like a U-turn to Hippowdon. And he gets a crit there, and he hits all of them. Okay, well, that's really good. But now the Hippowdon can just heal up, and I don't love that. I feel like Ox probably should have just switched there, but hey, the drone, I guess it worked out. So now we're in a 5-5 game, and I feel like it favors Ox a bit more than it did before. We see Clef here, so Clef comes in on a Slack Off, probably can, you know, try and display some items or, you know, force some stuff, but we'll have to wait and see. Gonna be a Moonblaster there. Another Moonblast, it's especially defensive Hippowdon, as you can see from the damage, he slacks it off, and kind of in a bit of a stalemate here, I'd have to say. I don't know who's gonna give first. If the Ferrothorn has Leech Seed, I'd imagine he goes to it eventually, but I mean, eventually, could be now, could be in 10 turns. Mandibuzz, he can come in as well, as it's burnt and it's not knocked off, so he's not going to be risking taking the Toxic, which, again, is why the burn play before taking the Willowisp from the Dragapult was the right play. So you'll have to wait and see. But yeah, no. Well, at this point, we're going to have to wait and see. Honestly, one of them is going to have to give. I'm not really sure which, and I'm too lazy to do the math with the PP to figure that out, so, yeah, no. Anyway, at this point, I'd have to imagine that the play probably is to just go for the, soft boiled here eventually, if you're Ox, just to heal up a little bit, try and finish this 1v1 at full health. And the issue with not having something like, say, Combined on Clef, or even, like, you know, knockoff. Actually, it's already knocked, so yeah, it doesn't really matter here, but not being able to touch things like a Powdown and Drill, it can definitely be a bit lame. I accidentally clicked on the Uber's game. Sorry about that. We see another move last there in Earthquake. All right, that's going to leave the Clef well below half, so he's definitely going to have to heal up here. see a soft pile down a slack off, and oh yeah, just trading Moonblast. Okay. Toxic on the Clef is a smart play there as it sets it up for Dragapult. And we see a crit there. So I guess it kind of puts Ox in the driver's seat. You had to get all the way up to full, and now maybe Ox switches out, but no, Ox is just gonna fish for it. That's fine. It's at 9 slack off versus 16 Moonblast, so it's at roughly the same pace, and we see 12 Earthquakes versus 12 soft piled, and yeah, so it kind of favors Clef just a little bit, but I mean, if you lose all your Moonblast, that's really good for Dragapult, so I guess that means he's going to have to crutch on Mandibuzz a bit, but I don't see why he wouldn't just go Mandibuzz in the first place anyway, just have both of those options there. As Clef's also really good against the opposing Mandibuzz, but I'm not the one playing this series, so yeah, we see Ferrothorn coming now, presumably on a slack off. Yeah, okay, that's good for Ox. Is it going to be Leech Seed? It's not, it's just spiking up here. So it spikes plus knock plus presumably power whip plus presumably like Thunder Wave or... Oh, he had it the whole time. I give up. We're going to see, man, please go for double leech here. Knock. I don't love that knock. That was nonsense. Like, what was he switching to? He was going to knock. Is it just not power whip? I feel like it should be power whip for Primarina, right? And that Primarina is actually at full on the back. Wait, he goes to Primarina on this, but wait. I guess we'll find out now. And it's not. Oh my god, it's not whip. It's not whip. Wow, I really disagree with this team choice from Ox then. I think he really needed whip on this team. I don't see how Bea can lose with this now then. This looks really good for Bea. Clef comes in here now, but yeah, Skull is going to do a nice 30% to it, and presumably the Primarina is quicker, so I could just go for the Commander to sub here. It should be EV to live the Moonblast, and so I assume we see sub. Yeah, sub here. And now, okay, is it whip or not? Scald here, is it gonna burn? No burn, it's body press. Wow, so that's not gonna do the trick at all. I think this was the wrong choice of moves on Fox's side, I gotta say. We see another body press, it does break the sub, but you can just sub up again here. Not wanting to risk anything. He actually just goes for the Scald. I don't love that play on the body press though. I feel like knock, probably should have just knocked the fish there. But okay, subs here now, and I think that not subbing the initial place was a misplay there by Bea, risking it unnecessarily for like no reason whatsoever, but I don't think it matters. This is going to win regardless at this point. So it looks like Bea is going to advance in this series. Honestly, I wouldn't be shocked if he just goes for an attack here into the Mandibuzz. Yeah, I think he just moved last year, just to be on the safe side. You sub here, so yeah. Wait, oh, misclick, damn. So he attacked. He attacked, but it worked because he went zero orb, predicting the sub. Yes, it actually worked out, ironically enough. And now we're going to see again fast rip here, and again, presumably slower Primarina. And now Mandibuzz can just roost this off. Wait, why would he go up? What? I don't understand that sequence, but okay, that works, sure. Now we're going to see Primarina coming again here. Soft boiled, and now we're going to see sub here. It does eat the Moonblast, and yeah, that'll do the trick. Hopefully, anyway. Another one breaks. Actually, wait. You can sub here because sand runs out at the end of the turn. Yeah, you can sub here. So, you just go for the sub and that should be enough. Well, I guess not. Yeah, as you see, sand runs out here. So, sub would have been fine. And then you could have took Yoda behind this. Whatever. It does make a big difference. Moonblast there. Yeah. If here, I can come in and try and, like, revenge kill you. Sure. But that's not going to do the trick, unfortunately, along. No. I think you just let this go here to the right period, right. And then from there, well, is the Dragapult set? It's Wisp. Yeah, you get the Wisp off, then it's fine. Never mind. Sorry, I was like trying to overcomplicate. And if you miss Wisp, let's say this is faster, then you miss Wisp. It has to lock into Stone Edge. So, he'd also have to crit the Mandibuzz on a Roost. And then, I don't think he'd beat the Powder. Yeah, I just don't think there's anything. Unless it's, like, Ice Punch. Ice Punch should kill this. And it should, okay, he goes Mandibuzz first. I guess that just means that, yeah, Powder's gonna wall, dude. Okay, that's fine. It's on his mid. Okay, the game's over. Good game. Alright, so Bea's gonna win in the best of three against Oxtafox. A really tight set, closely contested. Good games. Congratulations to Bea on advancing. And hey, great run to Oxtafox as well. You got a bright future ahead. And I hope Bea continues to play deep into the tournament. I'm really looking forward to his games. And yeah, all right, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this set. Thank you for watching and have a great day. All right. Peace, guys. Bye.